Dial up the dream. Make your daughter's journey to adulthood the best for both of you. Written and narrated by Colleen O'Grady. Additional content by Paul Stefano. Dedication. I dedicate this book to every authentic, imperfect, and invested mom who desires an ongoing and gratifying relationship with her daughter as she journeys to adulthood. Not only is mom committed to her daughter's dreams, she wonders what's possible for her. On her good days, she knows there's a dream for her too. Introduction. I told my 25-year-old daughter I was headed to La Jolla, California, to write the introduction to this book. "Can I come?" she asked. Well, I was dubious at first. At home in Houston, it only takes one dirty window to distract me from writing. Having her in my sightline, my favorite person in the world, the best of all possible distractions, no way would I get any work done. So, of course, I said yes. And no, I didn't do any writing for the 2 days she was with me. I had to extend my trip to finish this introduction, and yes, the delay was absolutely worth it. During our time together, we watched the seals in La Jolla Cove as we drank our morning coffee. We found fun places to eat, hike, and lie on the beach. She got a mani, I got a pedi. We poked around art galleries. She, quote, needed to buy sunglasses, and we both bought earrings. Last night, as we watched the sunset over the Pacific, she took a selfie of us with the sun shining through one of her new hoop earrings. Through it all, we talked and talked. In this relaxed space, she told me about all the good things in her life, her business expanding and her committed relationship, and she shared her struggles too. This time and these conversations are precious to me now that she lives in another city. Also, because it wasn't always like this. She left this morning at 5 a.m. to catch a plane home and return to her adult world. Her boyfriend is picking her up from the airport. These goodbyes are never easy, though I know I'll probably see her in a couple of months. During these mini reunions, I'm on top of the world. Such visits are the premier jackpot of dopamine hits for a mom. But visits are temporary. And it stings every time I say goodbye. As she nears 26, our relationship is such a blessing to me. She continues to get me out of my routine, inspire me, and teach me how to have fun. From drama to dream. If you told me 8 years ago, as my daughter is entering her senior year in high school, that I would A, have full confidence in her making a pre-dawn flight on her own, B, feel at peace with her ability to make big life decisions, not to mention run a business, and C, be sad when she left, but also kind of excited to get back to my life? Well, I would have wondered if you'd ever met me. Now, as I look out over La Jolla Cove all by myself and settle in to write, I think about all the twists and turns I and every mom experience as our daughters slowly make the move from living under our roofs and by our rules to independence and figuring out their own rules as they inch towards their dreams. I think about how in the last 8 years my relationship with my daughter has changed, grown, and matured as she walked, sometimes stumbled, towards adulthood, and as I walked, often stumbling, toward becoming the mother of an adult woman. As a marriage and family therapist with a private practice specializing in the mother-daughter relationship, I've spent the last 28 years helping moms and their teen to young adult daughters positively navigate the murky waters of these transformative years. My last book, Dial Down the Drama, provides moms with the insights and strategies needed to successfully manage their daughters early to mid-teens while keeping their relationship strong. This book, Dial Up the Dream, focuses on the stage of development from the late teens through the mid-20s, when your daughter takes flight and begins to build her own life. In some ways, this emerging adult stage can be more stressful on both mother and daughter than the teen years, because the stakes are higher and the changes to the relationship more profound. Of course, each stage of parenting has its unique trials and difficulties. What makes this emerging adult stage exceptional, though, is how unprepared most of us moms are for it. We all know to brace ourselves for the turbulent teens, and when we're up to our necks in our teen's drama, we cling to the belief that when she finally leaves home, the hard part of parenting will be done. Even better, our mother-daughter relationship will be good again. That's not how it works. The drama and rash decision-making don't miraculously disappear at high school graduation. They dissipate slowly. over the next several years as her brain develops towards full maturity, which typically occurs around the age of 25. Yet at 18, she'll be regarded by the law as an adult. While her brain is still forming, she'll likely move out of your house, live independently for the first time, and make career and relationship decisions that could impact the rest of her life. If you feel your mommy dar going off about now, I get it. As you look at your 18-year-old daughter today, over-emotional, naive, and shockingly impulsive, you rightly wonder if she's up to the task of separating her laundry properly, let alone keeping herself alive. Though you love her and believe wholeheartedly in the person she's becoming, you honestly question the wisdom of allowing her to live anywhere or make any decisions without adult supervision at this point in her development. Adding to the tension is that your world is changing too. As she gains her independence, you're losing a job that's defined you for nearly two decades, a job you love. While she gets ceremonies and congratulations to mark each milestone, there's no other ritual or even acknowledgement for the changes in your life. After talking with the mom about her 19-year-old daughter, she messaged me this. As a mom, you're just supposed to keep smiling as you wave goodbye. Of course, I want my daughter to be independent and have a life she loves. But at the same time, her leaving has left me with an ache in my heart and a hole in my life that I'm not sure what to do with. Sometimes I get so sad not seeing her every day, even though half the time she lived here, I was mad at her. But there's no space for mourning and no one to talk to about it. Especially if your child is doing well. You feel like a self-absorbed jerk for being sad. I always wondered if any other moms felt like this or if I was just crazy. Rest assured, a lot of other moms feel this way. I see them all the time in my practice. Also, rest assured, your role as mom is not coming to an end. It's simply changing. Your daughter still needs you. And since you're the only one in the relationship with the fully formed brain at the moment, not to mention life experience, it's up to you to see both you and your daughter successfully through this phase in her life while keeping your relationship strong. How to do that? What you need to know and understand, and the strategies, tools, and practices you need to put in place are all found in these pages. This Way to the Dream, What's in This Book? Dial Up the Dream is the book my clients have been requesting for years. It's the book Dial Down the Drama readers have been asking for now that their daughters are graduating from high school. And it's the book I wish someone had given me when my daughter was taking those first steps towards independence. This book validates what you are feeling and experiencing with your daughter right now, beginning with her late high school years and moving stage by stage to her young adulthood. It lets you know what to expect next, how to manage it, and how to be there for her in the most supportive and helpful ways, whatever comes. In these 12 chapters, you learn exactly what's going on with her emotionally and physiologically, and how to use this science-based knowledge to set realistic expectations, reduce tensions, and not take her behavior personally. How to think about and navigate the many complex feelings in this journey for both you and your daughter. How to get the most from your daughter's last years at home and create a home she wants to visit once she moves away. The most common emotional traps we moms get caught in during these years and how to avoid them. Why it's imperative to change your parenting role from monitor to trusted consultant and how to do that. How to judge when your intervention in her life is called for and when to let her find her own way. What to do and what not to do when your daughter suffers a major setback and why she probably will. Why you must recognize and heal your own mothering trauma and how to do that. How to use this new phase in your daughter's life to dial up your own dreams and why doing so is imperative to your daughter's development and to having a vibrant, meaningful, lifelong mother-daughter relationship. Each chapter ends with an exercise so you can put what you learn into practice immediately. The dream is within your reach now. After nearly two decades together, the emotions and identities of mothers and daughters often become entangled like a drawer full of old necklaces. Through what you find in this book, you can free yourself and your daughter from those parts of your relationship that snag you and keep you stuck. You can move into this next stage in your mother-daughter relationship, having smoothed out the knots between you and shining side by side as two adults, each in your unique way. This emerging adult phase can be confusing, confounding, and even painful at times, but it is also an amazing time of personal growth for your daughter and for you. When you approach it with an understanding of what's happening and why, knowledge of how to manage it, and a fully open heart, this time of transition lays the foundation for her dreams and yours, and for a relationship you both will cherish forever. Mom, I know you are more than up to the challenge. Chapter 1, The Junior-Senior Parenting Zone. Jen had just come home from work, wearing a white jacket, black skinny jeans, and red pumps. Her makeup looked fresh. Her long hair had soft curls that were impressively still in place at 6 p.m. Just beneath that perfect exterior, however, I sensed exhaustion as she walked through my office door. "How can I help you?" I asked. "I'm miserable," Jen said, before she even hit the couch. "My daughter Emily is a senior in high school. I don't know if I'll survive the year. She's being a total hornet. Every time I bring up something about her college applications or her college essays, she pushes back with a rapid, "I know, I know, I know." Obviously, she doesn't know, because her grades are dropping and she keeps procrastinating. Everything with her is a huge battle. She's either in her room with the door shut or she's out with her friends. When she does talk to me, she's just mean. We both took a breath. If you're struggling with your junior or senior high school age daughter, you're not alone, and you're not imagining the trials ahead. In this stage of her growth and your parenting, there are so many challenges, obstacles, stressors, and traps for the mother-daughter relationship. But there are also so many opportunities to revel in the person she's becoming and to be there for her as she takes her next step to claiming her own life and dreams. I know because I've lived it with my own daughter, who's now 25. I've also spent more than 50,000 hours as a licensed marriage and family therapist and coach, helping moms and daughters navigate this perplexing passage. What I shared with Jen in my office that day and what I'm sharing here with you is that from those late teen years and into their mid-20s, our daughters can be unwise, immature, and unrealistic. And yes, overly dramatic about everything. But what I found in my practice and through my personal experience is that we as mothers sometimes make things worse, even when we think we're being helpful. But that doesn't have to be. By becoming more self-aware and by better understanding where your daughter is developmentally through each phase of her walk to adulthood, you can make things better for her and for you. With a little knowledge and the right tools, you can learn how not to react to the drama, but instead to act from a place of belief in her and the desire to support her as she does the difficult work of maturing. As she slowly makes the transition from teenage girl to adult woman, you can ensure she has the space she needs to develop the self-confidence and life skills to eventually take full responsibility for herself. And you can do it all the while keeping the bond between you strong. Where Jen, and maybe you, are right now, that last year in high school and at home, most of the drama between mother and daughter is caused by our laser focus on our daughter's future. It's hard to be present in a relationship when your mind and mouth are always running 6 months ahead. But by focusing on the here and now, and by using this last year or so at home to prepare our daughters for the independence that's just around the corner, we can be responsible parents and at the same time enjoy our kids. We can ensure our daughters have what they need to launch into life while also relishing the time we still have with them, allowing them to continue to brighten our lives with their energy, playfulness, and their anything-is-possible spirit. Though your daughter is less dependent on you and spending most of her time with her friends, you're still important to her, even though she acts like you're not. You are a stabilizing and comforting presence in her life. The voice of reason as she prepares to leave home. The truth is, she needs you now more than ever. If moms could go there again. When we're on the verge of milestone moments in life, we often have trouble distinguishing what's truly important and what just isn't. Like bridezillas, we can overreact because we are fearful. We can be over the top controlling and critical. In other words, not fun to be around. So I asked my community of moms, what would you have done differently in your daughter's senior year in high school and I loved their honest responses. I'd educate myself better on how to respond during conflicts. I try harder to parent my teen without being so afraid, and I'd learn not to take things.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.